The last time I surprised you like this, it ended up with you pulling some of your hair out. At least we avoided that this time around.
What do you mean?
All right. I don't like seeing you more than you like my visits, but we are a part of each other. For better or for worse, like some kind of twisted vow you didn't know you took.
Yeah, well, I want a divorce.
You know that's not how it works. Unfortunately, I'm here to stay.
All right, let's just go over the list of why you're terrible. You show up at the absolute worst time. You won't go away no matter what I try, and you insist on saying the worst things about me. And then go back to being all buddy-buddy when it's finished, which I don't understand at all, by the way. Like, where did that fit
you? Oh, please. I would never stoop to the level of being completely nice to you. Don't insult me like that.
I just don't understand. I was doing fine. You left me alone all summer and well into October. And now I feel like I see you every week. The anxiety attacks, the cycling in my mind while I'm in class or with friends. You've never been this awful.
Well, you have more on your mind than you think. Sure, junior year is stressful, but let's think outside of the box with your problems. Besides, we've established that winter is the best time for depression in me.
It's November. My seasonal usually goes into effect in January.
Ah, well, I had an early opening this year. As for my shorter visits, I always come for a reason. I think having a purpose is important.
You're not real.
Darling, it doesn't matter if you think I'm real or not. I'm here, I'm you, we're one and the same. We're a part of each other whether you like it or not. Now, what did I walk in on?
I was creating an essay.
Wrong.
What? I was.
Nope. What did I walk in on? This essay was actually just a very bad distraction. A very bad distraction to the other issues that you're trying to deal with and work through right now. Now, let's get to the nitty-gritty, put our hands together, put those couple of brain cells you have left together, and figure out what we've got on our hands.
No. No, absolutely not. No fucking way.
Jesus, we have this conversation literally every time I see you. Why can't you wrap your head around this?
It's not that I can't wrap my head around it. If it were true, I could totally wrap my head around it.
Well, obviously not, because it's true and you haven't wrapped your head around it.
What the hell do you know?
Everything. Remember, I am the personification of your anxiety. How you choose to deal with me is your choice. But at the end of the day, we are one and the same.
But I don't think this is real. This can't be true.
It doesn't matter whether you think I'm real or not. At the end of the day, what did I walk in on?
I was writing an essay.
And
I was taking a break from writing an essay.
Warmer.
That's as far as I'm going.
No, it isn't.
I was taking a break from my essay by scrolling through Facebook.
Warmer, and then?
That's it.
Who's Facebook?
Nobody in particular.
False.
Nobody in particular at first.
And then?
I saw her, and I went to her profile, and I just looked through everything again, like I do all the time. Because it's better to look here in the safety of my room than to look in person and tell her or anybody else how I feel about her.
Look at that, folks. Our favorite member of the League of Lesbians has finally realized her true powers. Tune in next week to see if she can break the mold and defeat her arch nemesis, cargo shorts. Unnecessary. Still unnecessary, but I'll forgive you in light of the fact that you're kind of going through a lot right now.
Yeah, and no thanks to you. I don't know why this is still a problem. I came to terms with the fact that I'll never be with her because she doesn't like girls.
Right. But that is not why I keep coming back. Think bigger picture.
I'm scared. I have friends and family who will support me, but it doesn't matter if they accept who I am if I don't accept who I am. And for some reason, I can't do that.
Well, Emotions have never been your strong suit. What? I'm serious. The fact that we've had this conversation several times proves that.
So you'll leave once I finally accept the fact that I'm gay?
Oh, honey, no. I'm sorry, it doesn't work like that. But think about this. Process this, take it off your plate, and I come around a little less frequently.
It's that simple.
Not in the slightest. Unfortunately, I'm here to stay.
I just don't get why this is so hard.
Well, think about it. If you're able to accept who you are, then maybe at the end of the day, things will be okay.
Really?
No, no, no. What about your parents?
What about them?
Well, think about it. Sure, they're pretty chill, but that's with all your cousins who have come out over the years. Let's face it, your family doesn't exactly walk in the straightest line. And their little girl, who, when growing up, wanted to be a princess with a handsome prince by her side. And what if your mother can't take this blow and thinks this is another secret that you've been keeping from her for all these years and just loses it?
I don't know.
What and your friends. I mean, you guys have been so affectionate your entire lives. What if they think you're going to start making passes and things get weird?
That's ridiculous.
And let's not forget this little crush, shall we?
What are you talking about?
Think about it. You guys are around each other all the time, especially when you're out and about. It's not like you're strangers. Picture this. You're off on one of your infamous drinking binges. You know what I'm talking about. And suddenly, out it comes. Your drink is all over her, and so is your confession of your undying love. You start babbling on about her golden locks and haunting
your eyes!
Dollface, we gotta think about everything here. I mean, worst case scenario of this thing. I'm here to help you.
No, you're not. You're here to make my life miserable by telling me that I'm a bad person and I'm not good enough to deal with what I've dealt. Well, guess what? I'm calling bullshit. Maybe there's no getting rid of you. Maybe I'm stuck with you for the rest of my life. But I don't have to let you control me like this.
Anything else you want to say?
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with lesbians. We've got Ellen DeGeneres, and everyone loves her.
All right.
Fair point. Oh, that's more than a fair point.
So, we good?
Yeah, but I still think you're a bitch.
Oh, thank God. I thought I'd lost my status in your eyes.
You know, I don't appreciate the initial onset of the trauma with the panic attacks and all, but these things usually turn out to be more productive than most of my therapy sessions. They're just so self-reflective.
Whoa, that's like way existential, dude. Oh, come on, give me my cheap shots. Just don't start talking to yourself in public.
Deal. Okay, now I need to write that essay.
What's it about again?
Oh, it's for my classical literature. An analysis of Sappho's poetry and the culture of Lesbos.
Christ, it's like the shit writes itself.
Okay, you're done. Get out.
Whatever. I'll be back next week when you start debating whether or not to tell the folks. Good luck in writing that essay and being hella gay 101.